Badra, my colleague and me, we both work for Nature Conservation Foundation. We are hosting this wonderful talk by two amazing naturalists who have been my favorites. And for those who live in Bangalore, Deepa and Chandu need no introduction. They are amazing naturalists and they're always ready to volunteer for any biodiversity program surveys that happen within the country. Let me just talk a bit about Deepa. Deepa is a wildlife volunteer. And she has taken the wildlife training program, which was run by the Karnataka Forest Department. And like Chandu, she took the very first naturalist training program run by the Jungle Lodges and Resorts in Karnataka. And she has attended some wildlife conservation programs in Wildlife Institute of India, Dehradun. She has also participated in many birds and butterfly surveys in India in many national parks in different parts of the country. She enjoys taking children and adults out on birding trips. In fact, Chandu and Deepa have conducted many nature walks together. She works with several schools and institutions like IIMB, IISc, and has been conducting the monthly fourth Sunday walk for Bangalore, the BNG Birds, which is an umbrella birding group in Bangalore. And Chandu also likes spending time outdoors and he enjoys sharing the wonders of nature with children and others. Bird watching sparked his interest in nature and he has participated in bird surveys and volunteered for multiple bird and nature walks. He's a software engineer by profession and naturalist by passion. Since Deepa and Chandu, like all kind of life forms, be it insects, spiders, butterflies, birds, it's always fascinating to go out with them on the nature walks. So I'm going to now let Deepa take over this talk. But before I do that, I would just like to inform you that we have kept everyone's audio and video off so that we have a smooth session. And if any of you have any questions, please type it in the chat box and we will take it towards the end. Thank you. And over to you, Deepa.
Thank you, Mittal. Thank you for that very glowing introduction. I am trying to recognize myself in that. Welcome, everybody. We are very happy to see so many people there because I had just told Mittal and Subhadra that I expect about four people or five people. So I am very happy to see that so many of you are here. Welcome to everybody. And we are just, this is just a short introduction to those which animals which fly amongst the flowers. So let's go ahead. So what we, here I am, this is me a few years ago. This was actually taken at Wildlife Institute of India at Dehradun, and that is Chandu. I am not able to understand why the slide is not. After this presentation, what we feel that you will be able to do is, even if you started from scratch, you will be able to know and identify butterflies, watch butterflies and their life cycles, connect what you learn with what you see around you in nature, whether it is in your gardens or in the forest. And not only that, you observe, question and seek answers to learn more about butterflies and insects. And last but not least, try and do what I do. I try and share what I learn with others so that we spread the joy of nature around to everybody. So let's start with the features of a butterfly. I'm sorry, are you also seeing a window which says, please move this window away from?
Yes, Deepa. Can you, you can drag if it is going away?
No, it is not. Anyway, please just ignore it.
Yeah, it's gone.
Yeah. The basic, this one that I would like to tell you is that of the many six-legged insects that fly, we have butterflies and moths, and there are a good easy ways to identify a butterfly. What you can do is you have the three body parts, which is the head, thorax and abdomen. We have the three pairs of legs. We have the forewing and the hindwing. And then we have the compound eyes, which is what, you know, makes the butterfly fly away before you get within 6 inches of it, which makes life very frustrating for all of us who love to watch the butterflies. What we like to do, just a minute. And the main this one that we use to distinguish butterflies from moths, apart from the fact that in general moths fly at night, butterflies fly during the day, the main difference that we see is that butterflies have these clubbed antennae, whereas moths have often very often they have feathered antennae. That is one way to tell a butterfly from a moth. And also the fact that moths in general sit with their wings spread open, and butterflies in general sit with their wings closed. Particularly when you are looking for an open wing, they will sit with their wings closed and they will tease you. I'm sorry, this one is taking a little bit. You all know the life cycle of butterflies. The butterflies, like many other insects, go through this amazing and miraculous process called metamorphosis. They start with the eggs, they turn into larvae, often five different caterpillars of different forms. Then they turn into a pupa, which is also called the chrysalis, and then the butterfly emerges from the chrysalis. We'll start with a few of the very common butterflies that you will see around you in the garden. As probably most of you know, now you can say that you had a tiger sighting on this presentation, because this is the plain or the common tiger. Now in the layout, what Chandu has done is, in the main picture, you have always the main butterfly, and up above in the left, you have the closed wing, which can look very different from the open wing of the butterfly. And then to the right, he gives you the larval form, that is the caterpillar form, and then he also gives you the host plant, which is very important, because if you see the plants, you will know what butterflies to look for. So this is the plain tiger, and you can see, are you able to see, just 1 minute, are you able to see the caterpillar now and the host plant? The host plant is the milkweed or the calotropis. Now we come to this one is also slow, I am very sorry. Now we come to another tiger, which is called the striped tiger, which actually does remind you of the tiger burning bright in the forests of the night. And you can see how the closed wing looks. The larva of the butterfly itself has this black and orange coloration, and this too uses the calotropis or the milkweed as a host plant.
Deepa, you can press on that pause button instead of play, so you have the manual control.
Yeah. Okay. Now we come to a couple of very interesting butterflies which are actually migrating right now. We will talk about migration later. Here is the blue tiger, and of the blue tigers, Chandu has chosen the dark blue tiger for the photograph. You can see the butterfly as it is. You can see that flower is a very small one, so it gives you an idea of the size of the butterfly. We are going from the larger butterflies and moving down to the smaller butterflies. So this is the dark blue tiger. You can see a similar coloration in this instar of the larva also. And then this is the tropical milkweed, which is called Asclepias. So this is the host plant for this particular butterfly. Many butterflies may have multiple host plants, but what we've tried to do is to show you the most common plants that grow wild and which grow in your garden without any great there also.
Deepa, just press on the next button, then the play button, it will be easy.
Yeah. It is taking a very long time. Now my internet is maybe acting up.
Just press the next one. Let me help you. Just press the next one. Yeah, click on anywhere, it will start showing one by one.
So here is the other butterfly that migrates. See, many of us, because of social media, we've heard of the famous monarch butterfly's migration from North America to South America. But what many of us do not realize is we have several butterflies that migrate within South India. They migrate from west to east and east to west. This is the common crow. And Chandu has included the closed wing. And he has also included this other variation of the crow, which is called the double branded crow. I wonder if you people can see the double brand over here on the wing of open wing of the butterfly. That is why it is called the double branded crow. Crows and blue tigers emigrate in thousands pre-monsoon and post-monsoon. Chandu will tell you more about it later. Oh my God, this is going very slowly. you have the caterpillar also. And this particular crow, Chandu, has also included the pupa, because A, it is easily, much more easily visible than the pupae of other butterflies, and it is a shiny mirror-like beautiful pupa that you can see under the leaves when you look for them. And the host plant of this butterfly is actually something that is very poisonous. It is the oleander or the nerium. It's very slow. I'm sorry, this one is a little bit.
It's fine, Deepa. Just click on anywhere on the slide. It'll move to the next slide. Just click on anywhere.
Keep clicking
on it. It'll start loading one by one. Just keep clicking anywhere on the slide.
Yeah, but loading is also taking a very long time. We did a mock at 1 o'clock and it was much faster than this. Is it showing? It's not showing on my.
Just keep pressing the next button and start showing.
This butterfly shares its name with at least one of its host plants. It is called the northern lime swallowtail. And the host plant is the lime, the lemon, and other plants of the citrus family. This is one butterfly that you often see the upper and the under wings all. You know, butterfly enthusiasts, they refer to it as the UP, that is the upper, and the UN, that is the under wings of the butterfly. So both are very beautiful, and you can see what a weird creature this one looks like, the caterpillar looks like. And the citrus family, any of the plants are what play host to these butterflies. It is very slow, Chandu. I am very sorry, it is going so slow. Now we come to another funnily named butterfly, which is called the common mormon. This is the male, which has this beautiful band across the wings. And Chandu has included both the male as well as the female form. Now, this female form, it mimics another butterfly. Chandu will talk to you later about butterfly mimicry. So, here is the closed wing of the male and the closed wing of the female. Here is the caterpillar, which again, when you look at caterpillars, you feel sometimes that you are in another universe entirely. And the host plant of this common mormon is something that all of us are used to. It is the curry plant, the curry leaf plant. It is one of the most common of the host plants. It is going terribly slowly. I do not know what has happened.
Actually, it's perfect, Deepa, because it gives us time to look at all the photos.
Okay, fine.
Yeah.
By the way, all the photos have been taken from Wikimedia Commons, where they have been contributed by various expert photographers. So we could not think of a better place to go to. Now we come to another large butterfly. This you may not see all the time, but when you see it, it is an utter delight. It is called the blue mormon. And though the scales reflect white on a photograph, it is actually black and a real lovely electric blue when you see it in person. You see the closed wing, which shows a little red also on the body, but it's very unusual to see it closed wing. It just sits with its open wings. And then here is the caterpillar. And the host plant is once again the citrus plants. After the mormon, I do not know why this was called a mormon, because a mormon is a sect of the people who live in America. It is a religious sect. Now we come to this very beautiful, this one, which is called the common rose. Now you can see the red head, and not only is the head red, if you can look at the closed wing picture, you can see that the whole body is red. This again is this one of mimicry. So that will be one of the distinguishing points that Chandu will tell you. look at this caterpillar. I really thought it was a sweet with a little cream dripping out of the sides when I first saw this larva. But that is the way it looks. And you can now see the host plant. This host plant is something which you may not have in all the gardens, but it does grow wild. And it is called Aristolochia. You can see it, if those of you who are in Bangalore may be able to see it in Lal Bagh. It does grow wild in the forest too. So this is the common rose. And next to the common rose, we come to another. Are you able to see the names, the common rose?
Yes, Deepa.
Yeah. After the common rose, we come to another rose, which is actually the crimson rose. This is a delightful butterfly, which right now you will see across gardens all over, urban and rural settings, you will find them. This is again the closed wing, and you can notice that the whole body of the crimson rose is red. You see, this is very similar to the larva of the common rose, except that there is no white band. This too has the host plant as Aristolochia. So I am not going by all the scientific names because I myself find it very hard sometimes to remember all of them. So now we come to a very, very common this one. This is called the emigrant. And I'm sure that all of you must have seen these limey, yellowish, green, bluish butterfly flying all around the gardens and in all the fields also. You can see the butterfly's proboscis, which it curls up and which it extends to nectar from a flower. And you can see, as usual, the club antennae, which mark a butterfly. This butterfly, it is not very easy to see the open wing because it's almost never seen, but that is what the open wing looks like. So we've taken the help of many expert photographers who have contributed these images. This is the way it looks. This particular butterfly that Chandu has chosen is the mottled emigrant. It's called mottled because of these lines on the body. In general, you might find them without the lines. Those are the common emigrants. E-M-I-G-R-A-N-T-S, emigrants. That is, which are flying away. Immigrants are those people who are coming into a country. Look at the beauty of the caterpillar. And the host plant for this, we have actually chosen two because it has many. The first one is one plant that flowers at the beginning of summer. That is called the flame of the forest, Beautia monosperma, or the palash, as it is called in Hindi. The second one is also an early summer flower, which is called Amaltas in Hindi. It is called the golden shower or the Indian laburnum. And the scientific name is Cassia fistula. So when you come across these plants, also look carefully to see whether you can see some butterflies or some of the larvae over there. Eaten leaves gives you a very good indication that there are caterpillars over there, busy munching their way to their next stage of life. Now we come to this one, which is named after some of the peerage of probably the British people who named these butterflies first. This is called the common baron. And here Chandu has included, this is the gaudy baron, which is a very beautiful variety of this baron that you may come across. And this is the female of the common baron. It looks slightly different from the male. Look at this caterpillar. I wanted to tell you that recently there was a WhatsApp forward which gave this picture of this caterpillar and gave the totally wrong information that it is poisonous and it will cause all kinds of horrific side reactions if it touches you. No such thing. Of course, it is good to keep your distance from caterpillars in general, from all wildlife in general, but please understand that it is not poisonous and not harmful in any way. The host plant for this is something we all relish. That is the mango tree, Mangifera indica. Euthalia is one of the very common families of butterflies. Now we come to yet another butterfly which shares its name with its host plant. This is the common castor. Now the common castor is of the castor is of two varieties. One is this, the common castor, and the other one is this in the insect, which is the angle castor. How do you tell between the common castor and the angle castor? Very simple. The answer is in the hearts. Look for the heart-shaped patterns on the wing. If you do not find them, you are looking at an angle castor. So here is the pupa, also exquisitely shaped with a beautiful pattern. So Chandu dug out this this one from the Wikipedia Commons and included it. You find the very prickly looking caterpillars, and the host plant, as the name suggests, is the castor plant. This grows wild all across our countryside, and of course it is also commercially cultivated for the castor. Now we come to a very pretty butterfly. Frankly, this is really my favorite. This is the common Jezebel. This also has a similar, this one called the painted sawtooth, which is not very common. And this has a very interesting almost achievement. As you know, the colors of Karnataka state are red and yellow. And because this butterfly carried these colors, it was in the running for the state butterfly of Karnataka. But you know what did this butterfly in? The butterfly's name. Some British person in the distant past had named it Jezebel. And Jezebel is the name of a woman of dubious reputation in the Bible. So our prudish government said that no, we cannot have a name like that. And the southern birdwing is today the state butterfly of Karnataka. But this is a very common butterfly. You will see it across all urban and rural landscape. You can see the open wing, which it doesn't show very often. You will also see the caterpillar over here. They look really fat and well fed, don't they? If you see these eaten edges of the leaves, you know that there are caterpillars around. And here is the host plant. Now this host plant also, I need to tell you, this is called mistletoe. Mistletoe, all of you have heard in connection with kissing at Christmas. But mistletoe is a parasite on other plants. And there is another interesting thing, the flowers can only be opened by certain birds. And these butterflies, they lay their eggs on the mistletoe. Those of you who have raised hands, I think Mithal will take this one. Srikesh has raised a hand. We will answer your questions after the presentation is over. So Srikesh raised his hand during the slide of the Jezebel. This is another butterfly with a slightly different, this one compared to the rounded shapes of the other ones. This has a more delta triangular wing formation. You will again see a lot of them right at this time. This is called the tawny coster. So there is the closed wing, which you will also see quite often. Here is the very weird looking caterpillar with, you know, keep off me spikes all over the body. And this has a very interesting host plant. This is the passion flower or passiflora. This grows wild all over. We also have some cultivated varieties which are purple or pink in color, but the wild flower is generally white and pink. And the fruit of this is very tasty to eat for humans as well. So when you look at the passion flower, look around to see whether you can find tawny costers nearby. Another very common butterfly, in fact, it reflects it in its name also. It is called the common grass yellow. Now, the technical term by the butterfly experts for this is two-spot grass yellow. I'm not going to go into that, but this is one butterfly that you will see all around you. This again, it doesn't often show you the open wing, but you can see the black borders. and you can see a slight indication of the black border around them. The caterpillar is green and a little spiky. And the one of the host plants is the jungly jilebi, Pithecelobium dulce, which is called Kudukapli in Tamil. I do not know what the name is in other languages though. And another common host plant is the gulmohar, which interestingly is not a native tree. Do you know that the gulmohar comes from South America, and yet this butterfly has adopted it as its nursery? That's something really interesting that I find. And the third plant is Cecilpenia pulcherrima, which is also called the peacock flower. This has multiple, this one. So we chose the three most common host plants. I must mention while the slide is changing that both Chandu and his son Virat have done a lot of work on sourcing these slides and putting the presentation together. So I am really thankful to them. This is another very small butterfly. Do not go by the size in the photograph. The size of the butterfly will be about the size of your thumb or a little larger than that. It is a beautiful butterfly called the common Pierrot. Pierrot is named after a character in the French Punch and Judy mime show. The Pierrot wears white and black clothes. Sometimes the Pierrot or many butterflies, what they do is sometimes they, at a certain time in the morning, they sit with their wings open, drawing energy directly from the sunlight. So if it sits at that time, you will be able to see this very beautiful open wing of the common Pierrot. You can see the very fat looking caterpillar again. And the host plant for this is the jujube plant. It is a kind of Sisyphus species. You will find the common Pierrot almost everywhere right now. Along with the common Pierrot, there is another kind of Pierrot which is even smaller than the common Pierrot. In fact, you might miss it because it is so tiny. It is about the thickness of your forefinger, that is all. And look at the underwing and look at the beauty of the upper wing. This, it actually reminds me of the red postman, which is a US butterfly. So it is black and red with beautiful white and red borders all around. Here you see the white and black spotted butterfly larva of it, and the host plant is called Calancho, which is the scientific name is Bryophyllum species, which is cultivated in many gardens. It also grows wild. This the butterfly is also very prevalent right now. It is the season for this butterfly.
Deepa, at this point,
I will ask Chandu to take over and introduce a few more of our common butterflies that he has put together. Over to you, Chandu.
Yeah, thanks, Deepa. While we move to the next butterfly, I just want to reiterate one thing. So butterflies have very strong connection with plants for their food as adult as well as for host plant for the larva. So certain butterflies eat only certain plant leaves, whereas some have more than one variety of leaves they eat as a caterpillar. So if you understand the connection, it's easy to spot and know the butterflies. That is the intent why we try to put all the common plants and common butterflies you see around, so you make the connection. Yeah. So moving on. So this is a very interesting butterfly. So just explaining how butterflies eat plants or leaves of the plant as a caterpillar. But this is an exception. So we have such nice exception. So this butterfly, as you see, is very small. Deepa, can you move to the next? Yeah. So this is called a fly. You hardly get to see it with the wings open. So rarely you get to see the wings open form. And it's I can call this as a non-veg butterfly. I'll explain why. So why it's called a fly, if you look at the pupae of it on the right hand side, so the shape of it looks like a ape. So that's another reason people say that it's called ape fly. And what is unique about this butterfly is unlike other butterfly caterpillar, it doesn't eat leaves, but it eats these mealybugs, which you would see on plants. There are actually, they feed on plants and then damage your plants in the garden or elsewhere. So this actually helps you keep them in control. So this is one exception butterfly. It's called ape fly, A-P-E, ape fly. Yep. Next one, Deepa.
So,
yeah, no problem. So now moving on, there's other butterflies called skippers, which all look like this. There's, they have a slightly thicker bodies and shorter bodies and short wings. And you see them all around. We thought we'll include one, which is very common, which you see around homes. So this is called common banded owl, which you would see as a caterpillar to the right. It feeds on a very common plant, which I'm going to tell. But as a caterpillar, it eats the plants and rolls the leaf and hides inside and pupates it and comes out. And the plant it uses is the Pongamia pinnata, which is very common across the avenues across the cities in India. So you'd see them in winter, the flowers, all pinkish flowers falling down on the ground, making a pretty picture. So these feed on this. So at, in Bangalore, for instance, a couple of years back, the area in HSR layout where the whole line of plants have been eaten away by this caterpillar and people were panicking, but then the plant survived and sprung back to life because there's a mass, I won't call it infestation, but a lot of these caterpillars were feeding and then they came out as a butterfly and went off and the plant survived. Yeah, so if you look, because these are common plants, if you walk past, you can look for the common banded owl sitting around.
Yeah, that is all the information we will give you right now. We'll go to the next slide.
Yeah. And so we will move on to a lot of other butterflies. So we will not be able to, probably it'll be too much for you to start, who are starting with butterflies, to give a lot of other info. So we'll show you some of the common butterflies you see. So these are families of butterflies called as jays. So the one on to the left is a tail jay, which usually uses your false Ashoka tree or the Kadamba tree as a host plant, as well as the common jay. These caterpillars also you get to see if you have either the Kadamba or the false Ashoka, both of them. But the one on the right, extreme right, is called a blue bottle, which almost looks like common jay, but it's more of a forest butterfly. You might not see it in the city. And all these are jays, common names of jays. The other set of commonly seen butterflies, which we call as tips, whether the one on the left is called yellow orange tip. So it's easy to remember the name of this butterfly. So it has a tip of the wing, which is orange color, and it has yellow color body. So you can just name it as yellow orange tip. Now you can guess the next one. You can just call it crimson tip, or you, if you wish, you can say white crimson tip, but we just call it crimson tip. And to the right is a white body and an orange tip. So it's a white orange tip butterfly. So there are a few other tips, but we thought we'd just show you a few of the orange tips and crimson tips, which are commonly seen when you go out. And there are other set of butterflies which are very pretty. You get to see commonly around your house. These are all called pansies. You get to see around six varieties usually around your homes. So the one on the left is called the blue pansy. As you go by the name, it's all bluish color with a nice contrasting red dots. And to the right is a peacock pansy. Other very pretty among the pansies. And all the pansies are very, very pretty. If you ask me to pick one, it's very difficult to say which one is. And the next one, the names you can pretty much guess. It's all brownish. Reminds you of a chocolate. Yeah, it's called a chocolate pansy. And the one to the left below is the yellow pansy. And the one next is a lemon pansy. Though it's slightly brownish, not actually lemonish color. And the one next to it is a gray pansy. It's all totally grayish. So if you remember how pansies look like, and you can easily remember the names when you see them out.
One minute, I have lost
them. It's okay. You can go back to that presentation, Flying Amoles. I think you clicked on the link. So Titus have provided the link, so that's why. You just go back to the tab, Deepa, where you are presenting the Google Doc. So it'll start again.
Where?
In the Google Chrome tab, wherever you're presenting the PPT is, you just go back to that on the Chrome window.
Just a minute.
So while Deepa is doing that, which
just
is
also, I'm not able to understand what I'm doing.
Can you just do Alt and Tab together?
Alt and
Tab together.
Yeah. Just a minute. Let me come back. Yeah. Sorry about that.
Yeah. So you can make it full screen like last time.
Yeah.
Thank you. That's okay. Thank you. So so these are all pansies. Yeah, that you get to see. They're also common. They're not big butterflies. They are slightly smaller than what you have seen so far. But they're common. And there are even smaller butterflies, what we call as blues. The reason why we call it blues, we will explain on the left side extreme small inlet photo. When they open their wings, they have all this bluish tinge. So that's why they're called blues. They're very, really small butterflies. So you have to, if you don't watch carefully, you might miss spotting them. And they have very interesting names also. So starting to the left, you can see it's a very funny name, Forget Me Not. So it's one and small butterfly and open wing, as you can see on the left.
The one I forget the most.
Yeah, you tend to forget most because if you don't watch carefully, they all look similar. But we try to include something which you can differentiate. So the second one is a zebra blue. So this is easy to ID because it has the zigzag patterns all over. It's all black and white. And this is an Indian Cupid. Again, Deepa Sahu calls it stupid because it's not so common. It doesn't sit for long at a place. And below is a common cerulean. Again, watch out. From here on, there will be subtle differences between species.
For the cerulean, I look for this dog leg over here.
Yeah.
Near that spot, I look for that dog leg. That gives me the common cerulean.
Yeah, so once you start observing them, you can make your own markings, which will help you identify them. Then followed by a pea blue and a pale grass blue. They're all blues, not so, which are common, but very small.
Yeah, there
are. Yeah. And we thought we'll show you some really beautiful butterflies. For instance, this is a peacock, banded peacock. Again, there are multiple varieties of peacock butterflies. They're really pretty. Bright, shiny, colorful, and reminds you of the colors of peacock. There are there are multiple varieties of peacocks found. The Western Ghats has a different peacock, and up Himalayas there's a different peacock. Some are found in dry areas, some are found in wet forests. And there is a southern bird wing. Bear with me, my daughter has become cranky.
I'll just talk about the southern bird wing while you put a picture.
Can you do that, Deepa, for a second?
Yeah. The southern birdwing is another very interesting butterfly. It is considered the largest butterfly in India. Though, of course, you know, there will be this one between the golden birdwing, southern birdwing, Sahyadri birdwing. And since the Jezebel lost the race, the southern birdwing is now the state butterfly of Karnataka. In fact, those of you who are watching from other states, make an effort to find out which is the state butterfly for your state. If there is none, maybe you can spearhead the movement to get a state butterfly. And then after this, while Chandu is putting his daughter Upeksha to rest, this is a very beautiful but very small butterfly. It is called the silver line. Can you see the silver thread running through the butterfly scales? It is so beautiful. And it's a delight when you come across it in the fields or the streams. This is called the common silver line. So this you can see from the size of the flower, just how big it is. So here you are looking at the largest butterfly. The banded peacock is also a large butterfly, but the silver line is quite a small one. And then we wanted to show you some butterflies which look very ordinary with their wings closed, but get their wings open and you get an utter surprise. This is the beautiful, look at the bright blue of this. And then since I showed you the largest butterfly, let me also show you what is considered the smallest butterfly in India. This is the grass jewel, which could be called the oriental grass jewel, small grass jewel. There is a black spotted grass jewel. But these are considered, as of what we know now, they are considered the smallest butterflies in India. Then you have this beautiful oak leaf butterfly. Now the oak leaf, when it is open, it is so spectacular. But the reason why you might miss it altogether is that it sits with its wings closed. And then it looks exactly like a dried leaf. So you we just tend to overlook it and move away. Chandu, are you back? No, I guess he is not back. Just let me go to the next slide. Now, I must mention this very, very special butterfly. This is the lilac silver fly. It is a very rare butterfly because it was thought to be extinct. And one of the founders of the Bangalore Butterfly Club, Nitin, he found this butterfly in the Hesargatta grasslands after a gap of more than 100 years. There are sightings from the northeast, but believe me, during the season, this season we have not been able to go actually because of the COVID. But if you go to the Hesargatta grasslands, I was myself able to spot 7 of these beauties. You can see that the silver line is slightly lilac purplish in color, which is what gives the butterfly its name.
I have
just talked about the silver lilac silver line, Chandu. You can add something if you want.
Yeah, I think you covered it. I just heard it. Yeah. Can we move to the next one?
Yeah.
So we will include few more butterflies. Sorry about the delay. We include few more butterflies which are very common. So one on the left is a danaid egg fly, which you also see. It'll have an egg kind of white spots on the wings. So that's why the egg fly name that you get to see commonly. And followed by few more common butterflies. Again, this one is also named after an animal. It is a common leopard. The one to the right is a sailor butterfly. So these are also pretty commonly you get to see in and around the town.
Yeah, and each of these has a specific, in fact, the sailor has a very specific gliding way of flying. Over a period of time with the familiarity by the flight itself, you can be able to identify some of the butterflies. Like birds, they have a different way of flight.
Yeah, so sometime back we talked about mimicry, right? So here is a nice story. So the butterfly you see on the right side is actually a tiger butterfly. Now the tiger butterflies, as we discussed earlier, they feed on calotropis, which is actually a little poisonous or toxic. So what it does as a caterpillar is it ingests that poison in its body, and when it becomes a butterfly, it has that toxic chemicals in its body. Now, when as a butterfly, if it flies, a bird or a lizard catches it and tries to eat it, it tastes really horrible. So they stop, they start avoiding the butterfly or eating that butterfly. Now, there's other butterfly on the left, which is called a danaid egg fly, which takes advantage of that. Now, what it does is the female, the male is an inlet, the totally black contrasting, but the female mimics this tiger butterfly so that no bird or any predator tries to catch it. So it will try to mimic it, but you see the slight differences. So that way it gets protection from predators. And similarly, there are other butterflies. There is the crimson rose mimicking butterfly onto the left, which is a mormon female. So sometime back we talked about mormon, right? So there's a female of mormon which mimics the crimson rose butterfly. It can mimic the common rose also. There are two forms of it. But the whole concept of this mimicry is famously known as Batesian mimicry. This is done by multiple insects, but in butterflies, it's very easy to know it because they're all around. And it's just to quote it, it's just a harmless species, which is in this case, danaid egg fly, trying to imitate warning signals of a butterfly, which is the tiger butterfly. It's trying to mimic its colors and shape so that no predator bothers it. Yeah, so this is something very interesting about mimicry in butterflies. So these are very commonly mimics that we're showing here. Yeah, we can go to the next one. And you can see the males and females are contrasting there. Okay, so talking about butterfly migration, there's something interesting. A lot of times when I talk to people about butterfly migration, nature walks, a lot of them seems to know about migrating monarch butterflies in the US, but many of them are not aware that similar migration happens in India. So there's researchers from NCBS who has worked, and of course multiple organizations and people worked and found that just before monsoon sets in around April or sometimes even March onwards, you'd see at least two varieties. There are more, but two are confirmed, the double-banded crow and the dark blue tiger. So these two butterflies, if you follow the yellow mark, so they
just before monsoon sets in, because it rains very heavily in Western Ghats, so they all fly using the monsoon winds as advantage towards the Eastern Ghats. Now, their next generations, after the monsoon finishes, they all fly back. You can see the red arrows on the picture. They all fly back in October, November, back to the Western Ghats when the rains have subsided and there's ample food and flowers. So this is documented by number of volunteers who across the country, across the South India, have documented it, took in the counts, and they migrate in thousands. So for us people in the South who travel, when you're driving down the road, or even if you're at home, if you see these butterflies flying in groups, in or flying in huge numbers in one direction,
you will really see rivers of butterflies flowing along.
Yeah, it's like huge flow, and usually it's on a sunny day. You'll see all this happening around, say, 9-ish to 2 o'clock or so. So this will all happen. So if you notice next time, just pay attention to see what kind of butterflies are flying and what direction they are flying. You can see this phenomenon happening right in front of your eyes. In fact, this year, there's a speculation that they started migrating early back. The post-monsoon migration started early. There's a bunch of them migrated last week. So there are other butterflies besides these two, that are double-banded crow the dark blue tiger. There are a few other butterflies you see migrating along with them, but there are two other butterflies, emigrants and common albatross. So these two also known to migrate in huge numbers. They call it local migration. Again, there is more study to do, but I'm not getting into scientific terms here, but you see them also migrate. Now we come back to a very basic question. Now, why are we even talking about butterflies? Why should we watch butterflies? So what is there? Yeah, so the simple answer, right? It's fun, the sheer beauty, you know, that we all like butterflies because they're bright, colorful. Yeah, that's one simple reason why we watch them. And other convenience is you don't need to go anywhere, or not always you need to go anywhere. You can be in your balcony and then just watch them. Or if you have a garden, terrace garden, you can watch them coming and nectaring. And of course, you can know as we went through this presentation, right? So we can understand about trees, insects, and their interconnections, how butterflies depend on trees for the life cycle, for food. And also, butterflies are indicators of health of ecosystems. So if there are more butterflies in an area, you know there's more varieties of trees and the ecosystem is doing good. So that's one sign. And also protecting the butterflies ensures that you protect the trees or plants, and that will also help other insects and animals. So that's another byproduct of this activity of watching butterflies. And trust me, once you get used to it, it's fun, because if you stand below the tree, you know what host plant it is. You can pretty much guess what butterfly comes around and sits there, or you can see butterflies laying eggs. So all that you need to do is have a patience, watch what the butterfly is doing and what plant you are watching. So once you do that, it's a lot of fun activity. Yeah. Deepa, you can just move on. I think there's some small glitch in the presentation. You can just move on.
It's, there is some glitch. Presentation is not moving.
It repeats two times. That's all.
For more information on butterflies.
So if you want to know more information about butterflies, you're just starting off. Well, here are some links that will help you. So in Wikimedia Commons, there are a lot of free images. You can use them as long as you give credit to the photographer. So some of volunteers put it together in Butterflies of Bangalore or Butterflies of Kerala. I think this is Butterflies of Maharashtra also. In Wikimedia Commons, they put it. So those images, you can use it as long as you give credit to the photographer. Besides, if you want to know more about what are the larval host plants, what we call as larval host plants or LHPs for each butterfly, you can find iPhone Butterflies. It's a very good website where where you find a lot of information about varieties of butterflies across India. Now, if you have a mobile phone and you click the picture of a butterfly and you want to ID it, iNaturalist is a very good app that you can use. Not only butterflies, you can use it for trees, insects, for a lot of other things. But if you have a nice cropped picture, it can also suggest you the idea of butterfly. Now, there's citizen science awareness. So it's avenues like iPhone Butterflies. There is India Biodiversity and iNaturalist. So you can use all of this to upload, so that whatever butterflies you see, that information help researchers in multiple ways. Yeah, next one, Deepa. So how can we help butterflies? This is the last slide. So we will move to a quiz after this. So how we can help butterflies Yeah, how we can help is you can plant the trees which will attract butterflies, either as a food plant or as a host plant, or you can also discourage or avoid using any insecticides or pesticides so that the caterpillars survive. And this is one other thing a lot of people complain, this is my plant, I have planted it, the caterpillars are eating it. But trust me, although a little damage, imagine the butterflies, you all know, are pollinators, a lot of fruits and vegetables that we eat, those flowers are pollinated by butterflies. So it's okay if, imagine it's a price that the plant is paying to butterfly for helping the plant disperse its seeds or pollinate, right? So you can think that way. And if you allow that damage, you can actually, at your home garden, you can watch the whole transformation of butterfly life cycle. And you can also contribute to citizen science initiatives by clicking pictures, by counting butterflies. There's a counting butterfly exercise going on right now as a part of Big Butterfly Month. So you can participate in that and provide your data. And also, you can share what we always say is, you can share whatever you know with others and you can end up learning a lot of these things. Yeah. Deepak, can the next one.
Yeah. Now, since we need to know whether you people have been actually watching or quietly dozing off while we bore you to death, we thought of having a few questions, just 10 questions as a quiz, just to keep our interest alive. So let me go to the first question. The first two questions, you will have to type the answer into the chat window. Please don't speak it out because we want everybody to have a go at it. So the first two questions are, one is match the butterfly with the caterpillars and second is matching the butterfly with their larval host plants. So the first one is a tonicoster. The second one is a common rose. And the third one is a striped tiger. So please match it to their caterpillars. If you feel that it is 1A, 2B and 3C, just type it into the chat window. And for the rest of the questions, what we will do is we will have a poll. And Chandu will help you to do the poll. So that all of you get your own answers. There is no competitiveness. You will each know how much your knowledge is.
There are no prizes as such. It's just for fun. Okay.
Yeah, it is just for fun. There is nothing competitive at all about it. Okay. We are just giving 30 seconds each. And now we will move to the next one.
Yeah, Deepa, you just press on the slide. It will show the answer. Yeah.
I should have waited for that. So this was it. The tonicoster is this very spiky looking gentleman over here. The common rose, as I told you before, it is this sweet dish with the cream leaking out. And the striped tiger is a tigery looking butterfly. So let's go to the next question, which is matching the butterflies, the common Mormon, the common Baron and the common Lime with their host plants. This is the mango, this is the citrus plant, and this is the curry leaf plant, curry patta. So please match what you think is right, and then after 30 seconds, we will give you the answer to this. So we deliberately kept it very simple. You know, we don't want too many multiple choice. Because I still remember my days in college when I had multiple choice questions and I was scratching my head right left and center. So the answer is, one is C, the common Mormon is the curry leaf plant.
Deepa, 1B can also be the answer. So if somebody says 1B, that's good.
1B is also correct actually. The citrus leaf is the citrus plant is also one of the host plants.
So for one, if the answer A or if you answer B or C, both are right answers.
Yeah, both are right answers. So we are making it very, very easy so that everything is right. The common Baron, it goes to the mango, this one to really 8-6. And the lime, of course, the answer is very simple. It will go to a citrus plant, lime, lemon, or any of the other citrus plant. Now, Chandu, just tell them how to do the poll.
Yeah, so the rest of the 8 questions that we have, you'll get a poll option in your Zoom. So you just need to answer the questions. Okay. So I think
Subhadra, anybody who has any trouble finding it, please put it on the chat window. Chandu will help you.
Yeah, here is the first question. How long, Deepa, you can move to the next slide so we can read the question also. So how long does it take for a butterfly that is freshly emerged from the pupa to become an adult? So a butterfly just emerged from the pupa. Okay, so how long does it take for it to become an adult?
Immediately it's going high.
Chandu, should I end the polling at the end of 30 seconds?
I think Subhadra will take care of it, Deepa.
Okay, fine.
We'll just wait for a few more seconds for people to answer, then Subhadra will end.
I'm giving 30 seconds, so I have to set it after. Thanks, 30 Subhadra. Seconds.
Sure, great, okay. Yeah, so I think most of you, I think Deepa, you go ahead with the answer. Yeah. Yeah, so yeah, most of you got it. I think majority of you got it right.
The unlike many other animals, the butterfly emerges as an adult. But how long it survives is the next one. Okay, should I go to the next one?
Yeah, Deepa. And the slide also, you can actually play them because we had the questions. If somebody has a problem seeing the questions on the poll, they can look at the questions on the slides also.
Yeah. Okay, we go to question 4. Which of the butterfly names below is not a common name of a butterfly seen in India? Your choices are crow, tiger, leopard, and hawk.
Hawk.
My goodness, I think we can end up polling, Subhadra. Oh, okay.
Poll question, you can see the timer on the right side top. So after 30 seconds, it'll end.
So Deepa, can you make this, the right?
Deepa, can you move the slides further so people can see the questions also? So if somebody is asking, they want to see the question.
Oh, I see. How do I do that?
The slides. On the slide, you can minimize the zoom poll window, and on the slides, you can move to the next slide, like what we've been doing now. Yeah. So the same question we just put it.
Yeah. This was the first question.
And you can move to the next one.
This is the second question.
Yeah, you can stop here. After the question comes on the poll, you can play here also. Yeah.
Yeah. So can we share the poll answer now? How do I go to the poll now?
I think you just need to tell the answer.
Oh, I have. Okay. Then the answer is D, the hawk. So most of you have got it right. The crow, the tiger, and the leopard are all found in India. The hawk is not found in. Okay. Now the next one is
Subhadra will. Yeah.
Yeah. Which is believed to be the smallest. It is believed. We all, of course, we have a lot of controversy, but it is believed to be the smallest known butterfly in India. So your choices are tiny grass blue, grass jewel, lesser grass blue, and common pierrot.
Yeah, time up. So you can reveal the answer, Deepa.
You can share the results. As of now, the grass jewel holds the position of the smallest butterfly known in India. But believe me, the tiny grass blue gives it a run for its money. And there are still expert controversies that are going on about it. So the next.
Move to the next question.
Which is, oh my God, why is it?
Subhadra will post the next question.
Okay. She is doing it then. Subhadra, you can go to the next question.
Or if there's a problem, maybe we can, on the slide also, we can show the question.
One second. Yeah. Just show the question, I will put it up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Which is considered to be the largest butterfly in India? Your choices are common jessamine, the blue mormon, the golden or southern birdwing, and the crimson rose. Thank you, Subhadra.
We have a few seconds left. Yeah, Deepa, you can reveal the answer.
Okay, again, most of you have got it right. It is the southern or the golden birdwing, which is the largest butterfly known in India. We are saying known because we still do not know what remains to be discovered. So, as of now, it is the largest, considered the largest butterfly.
Yeah, you can move to the next question, Subhadra will send.
What status did the common jessamine almost achieve? Becoming the Indian national butterfly, becoming the Karnataka state butterfly, becoming the logo of the Indian Foundation of Butterfly, which is I Found Butterflies, or becoming the logo of the 2028 Olympics? It almost got it, but it did not quite. So, which one is it?
Yeah, I think you can reveal the answer, but
yeah. Yeah, we will share the answer. Again, most of you have got it. Yes, as I told you, the jessamine had the colors of Karnataka in it, so it was considered as for the Karnataka state butterfly. But just because of its unfortunate name, it lost the race to the southern bird.
Yeah, I think next question is already there. So Subhadra can send the next question. You can read out the next question, Deepa. It's there already.
Yeah, it is there already. You can see it. How long can butterflies survive in the wild? 1 week, 1 month, up to a year, or all of the above? So Chandu and I were having a discussion. What happens if you see a butterfly and immediately by mistake you stomp on it? That butterfly has had a life of 3 seconds. That's why we are putting it in the wild. We are not saying with butterfly watches stomping on it.
Yeah, we have a mixed bag of answers.
Yeah, this you got quite a variety of answers.
Yeah. So the answer.
The answer is actually all of the above, because different butterflies have different life expectancies. So it could be start with 1 week and it could go up to a year. But then, because of the predators, because of difficult weather conditions, the fact that the butterflies are such delicate creatures, the lifespan may decrease. So this is one. This one where the answer could vary a bit. So this is a very, very simple one. I rather think that Chandu designed this question for me. So what is the pupal case of a butterfly called? Is it called a cocoon? Is it called a chrysalis? Is it called an utheka? Or is it called candy?
I'm surprised nobody choosing D.
Then everything would be... Yeah, let's see what everybody says. I strongly suspect the hand of Chandu's son in some of these questions. Okay, we can share the results. Yes, again, many of you have got it right.
So,
moths build cocoons, butterflies build chrysalises. Utheka is the name given to the egg case of insects like the praying mantis. And the candy is something that I hope we will go. I will now go out and get for my grandchildren in a little while.
Last question.
We have come to the last question.
Slightly tougher.
It is more for information rather than just being a question. Which butterfly's name is the same as the medal given by the British before independence to officers with outstanding public service in India? So you have Ashok Chakra, you have Kaisare Hind, you have the Paramveer Chakra, or you have the Sher-e Punjab.
Butterfly named after that medal.
Yeah.
We'll show you the butterfly picture next.
The medal butterfly is another spectacular butterfly. Okay, so we share the results with you. The answer is the Kaisare Hind. It is a butterfly that is found almost entirely in the Himalayan and sub-Himalayan region. And this was the name of the medal that the British gave.
Yeah, the next slide will show the picture of the butterfly, Deepa. It's a very rare butterfly.
We were very lucky to sight this butterfly last year when we went to Arunachal. It was very difficult, this one. We went in pouring rain with leeches all over us, but it was worth it for a sight of this very beautiful butterfly. This is called the Kaisare Hind. So I think that brings us to the end of this session of the answers and then the questions.